Best Linux for an old laptop. Here I have a Toshiba laptop from 2007, and it only has 1 GB of RAM. It originally had Windows XP, which ran super slow, and when it was upgraded to Windows 7, it became virtually useless. I've been experimenting with several versions of Linux which use low resources. Years ago, you had to be technical to install Linux, but now it is an easy process. Here is my resume for deciding on which Linux to install in relation to the power of the computer or laptop. I tested 3 different Linux distributions. First, Lubuntu. It's easy to install, but runs slow if you don't have 2 GB or more of RAM. Second, I tried Mint Linux, which also doesn't run too well if you don't have 2 GB of RAM or more. My third attempt was with Peppermint Linux, which runs okay on any laptop or computer with 1 GB of RAM or more. I'll take you through the install procedure for Peppermint Linux. Go to the following web link, which is also in the description below. You will find the download links for the 32 or 64-bit versions of Peppermint Linux. Virtually every computer sold after 2007 has a 64-bit processor, but it is better to install the 32-bit version if your computer has 2 GB or less of RAM, as a 32-bit Linux install uses less RAM memory. To install Linux on a laptop or computer, you'll need a USB memory stick with at least 4 GB. Now download and run a free program called Rufus from here. The link is also in the description below. On a working laptop, insert your USB memory stick. Open the Rufus software. In the upper part of the software window, the USB memory stick should appear under Device. Select where your Peppermint 32-bit ISO file is located. Hit the Start button. Confirm that you're okay with deleting anything on your USB memory stick. Close Rufus and eject your USB memory stick. Now insert the USB memory stick into your old laptop. Power on the laptop. We need to change the boot order via the BIOS. If you have an old Toshiba, you will need to hit F2 several times after the laptop has been turned on. I am now entering the boot menu and changing the order so the laptop boots from the USB memory stick first. Now I save the configuration and reboot. The Peppermint Installer boot menu will load. Select the option Install Peppermint OS. Choose your install language. Select your keyboard layout. You are now offered to connect a wireless network for updates. I prefer not to connect for now and will download the updates after the install process has finished. When you get to the updates and other software screen, select the normal installation and install third-party software to make sure that all the laptop's hardware will function as it should do. On the installation type page, I choose to erase the laptop's internal hard drive and install Peppermint OS. Now select your time zone. Create a username, computer name, and password. Sit back and relax whilst the install continues for roughly 15 minutes. When the install is finished, you will be prompted to reboot the laptop. After Peppermint Linux loads for the first time, I connect to my Wi-Fi and then proceed to update the OS and the software. Now I make a quick test browsing YouTube with Firefox, and it all looks good. And a 13-year-old laptop is running a modern OS at a decent speed. And one final tip, if your ancient laptop has an old hard drive with a SATA connector, I would recommend swapping it over to use a cheap SSD drive to vastly improve its performance. If you have any comments or questions, please put them below. If the video was useful, please consider giving it a like or subscribing to my channel. Many thanks.